come here to the symposium. I've been many times. I enjoy working here in the factory. It gives me a different, it enables me to work on other ideas, but with the restraints of the factory processes governing what I do. So that quite excites me. This year I'm working on the idea of the potato head, having read a book by the about plants by the aptly named Michael Pollan, in which he suggests that the potato is a good expression of the Dionysian. So I have been working on the theme of, in the beginning there was woman, she roamed the earth, sharp-boned, thin and sharp-boned, searching for a connection between herself and the barren earth. She roamed for 7 times 7,000 years until she came across potato lying on the ground, potato from the earth. She popped it into her mouth, or him into her mouth, and all of a sudden felt a swelling of her breasts and her thighs, noticed the birds thinning the skies, the plants rising up around her, and a thrusting between her legs. And out struggled potato head. Potato head, the male element, to complement the divine.
A long time ago, when I was, I think when I was a kid, I saw a pot. It was a teapot by a designer that was made by Rosenthal, and it was extremely fast. I mean, and it really grabbed me as a, I think it was, must have been something like, what, 17 years old? And the porcelain was just so incredibly beautiful that I started to read about porcelain, and I got really enchanted with the material. The material is, I think, one of the most beautiful materials in the whole world. I mean, it has the richness, the wealth of the old times. It has the incredible beauty. Lots of incredibly beautiful things were made in this material, and also a lot of terrible stuff. But no, I think the majority is really good. And so yes, this is. Porcelain is my material. I love it. Of course, you come to a symposium like this not to do your own work. That's one thing. I mean, of course, it will be your own work, but I came completely blank, completely as an empty space in my head. And I thought, well, it's let me be inspired by the material that is around. And so there was not a lot around in this place. So I chose the piglet. It's a piggy bank, and I chose this one. Clearly, I think shagging up a thing, this part will be gold, and the pigs are shagging the financial system. And that is really what is the idea at the moment. And for the rest, I've been putting some Lennons and Mr. Engels upside down, and I used them as flower vases, which I think was pretty funny. And it was lovely to do, because now you are here in a former communist country. And, looking at the history again, to put these guys that were the cause of all this, well, division in the world, to put them upside down, I thought was really funny. And to use them as flower vases, that I think was my idea of having a good time. These are more serious, and also having a good time. Yeah, and then I made these, which are just for the fun of it, because they were here.
I think those, like, defining moments, they make for good stories, but I'm not sure it really happens like that. I mean, for most people, I think it's a gradual thing,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I couldn't tell you what really got me interested in porcelain, and that was seeing the Meissen menagerie, the animals done by Joachim Kennele. So that was, I was really taken with them and started thinking a lot about porcelain. Great to just meet other people working with the same material and see how their approaches really differ. And I think that's the great thing about things like this. And of course, getting to come into a factory and actually make work is sort of, you know, that's, you know, the saying, being a kid in a candy store, and it's sort of, that's the situation, really. Although, you know, there's a lot of challenges that come along with just, you know, leaving your own studio and jumping into another situation where you know nothing really about the materials and the firing, and, you know, ceramics is a material that's so idiosyncratic, you know. The smallest changes can, you know, the results can be huge. Yeah, overall, I'd say it's been a lot of fun. I don't know if the work that I made in this symposium is going to be of much use to me, but I mean, I'm not sure that that's the point anyway.
And your work, tell me about your work.
About my work?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm really interested in, I look at a lot of art history, art of the past. I was an art history major. Before that, I was a philosophy and religion major. And then I started off my academic career as a biologist, so I sort of moved around quite a bit. And I sort of taken all those interests along with me, and it sort of forms up the backgrounds, the impetus to what I do. And looking at a lot of historical pieces that involve mythological themes, I tend to like to visit a lot. Religious, to some degree. Basically anything that I can sort of adapt to my own purposes. I don't know, what was the question again? I need to start over. Just getting too hyper. I mean, it varies quite a bit, but I mean, I guess I want to, a lot of the times I deal with madness or insanity, because I feel that we are kind of living, we're all sort of insane. We live a life that is destructive to ourselves, to the future of our race, to our children. And we do this every day, and we know it. And knowing it and doing it again, I mean, that is sort of the definition.
To work with porcelain from 1973.
And the symposium?
And symposium is from 1976.
And this year is the 30th?
Something like this. I don't remember. I think 13.5 or 13.4, something like this.
Mm-hmm. And this particular symposium, what have you enjoyed about this one?
In this year is just a crazy nice atmosphere. So all people are very friendly, and till now there was no one accident between us. Usually in the end of symposium the people start to be angry, they complain, they need something, or they are jealous. And not this year. This year is just very nice atmosphere.
That's wonderful. And your work this year, what work have you made?
I am making pigs. Pigs with red shoes.
So they're happy pigs?
Yeah, like all my animals, all of them are very happy. Sometimes the people ask me why they have so big white teeth and why they are so angry. And I said that now I answer, they are not angry. They are just taking care of you. If somebody will attack you, then my wolf can attack the bad person. I just love the moonshine nights when the moon is in the biggest and silver and shining so beautiful, and all my animals are waiting for this moment. The eyes, blue eyes, are shining in darkness, and I am happy. They are in my garden. I am living in a sort of fable.
How long have you been working with porcelain?
I don't know, several years.
And what touched you about porcelain?
Well, it's not about actually porcelain. It's about ceramic in general. And porcelain is just like, yeah, one of those departments that I'm enjoying at the moment. Mm.
And the symposium, what has the symposium done for you?
Well, it was a great opportunity to meet some folks from all around the world and to see how they're working, to get to know what kind of stuff they're making. Yeah, it's a great kind of think tank, actually. Yeah, a lot of fun. Yeah.
And your work, what are you making this year?
Yeah, I have this project. I have this project called Bumbing 2011, and it's about. I would like to show the situation, which is taking place at the moment, in our world actually, and it's about abusing the nature.
my work is about society connection and about people, about mass media, and about me. It's a really important step in my life because it was my first work with porcelain. I had many possibilities to work in some other clay, but porcelain, I touched porcelain the first time in my life, and I afraid that I fall in love so much. My new project, Artist Rebellion, is a Kakapupu story, or Kakapupu sorry, and it's a little bit about shit in our life, our work, and I tried to find distance to my work and find again how to play, not be the best or, you know, to sell or something. How to play with what I'm, who I am and what I do. And this shit is very important because inside is a dust from my brain. It's dust of porcelain, which I take when I make the smooth the brains. Porcelain brains, of course. So here inside is, I think, the piece of my work, think and atmosphere of this symposium.
Every action, what I'm doing, every art which I'm doing, is like be very close to the people, like this social meaning and the working with public space, like engaged people. I like when, you know, the art is like next to us. I'm always interested about this, what is going on now. Thinking what it will be if I will say to people, you can take one, you can you know, choose which you want, you can touch, you can feel it, and this shape which you like the best, you can take. So I made this first action with 1,000 pieces, all white, and it was like big happening. Gave me idea to do next this take art, like really really abstract object, which is object, but it is not object. So I just I'm doing abstract objects one more time, 1,000, and I'm just doing like, you know, just press here and make my signature and number, that every of them is like special. And then when it will be glazed and fired, it will be white, and I will put in some, you know, some small parts, like here, or like this small cube, gold, and fire it one more time, to give this feeling that it's something special, and which, you know, for me it's something like treasure, you know, when you find gold or something. This place is so, like, I feel so free that I decide I will make, you know, objects like more without feeling than without thinking. And this gave me this possibility here. I feel, you know, I meet people who have different techniques and, you know, many things which I don't know. And it's very inspiring. And I really like that, you know, people don't just push you, or I don't know how to say that. I feel like alone and with all of them in the same moment. Yes, and this I really like.
I think clay is a very humble material, and compared with glass, compared with painting, compared with those traditional material, and I decided this is the material I want to work with. I don't think it's 1 month time can change so much, but I think the conceptual influence, how I'm going to invoice your time and do my work, this led me to think different ways of working, different ways of thinking, and different ways of making. Because I exist because of her. And you really think, because that's my mother's Parkinson's disease started at the birth service. And so I decided my life, my thesis work, and it's going to be honoring my mother. Because I think the impact in my life and in my heart, how this language can cross into make a really strong, monumental feeling and direct contact from peace, from the material, into personal expression, into cultural influence of myself from this Chinese cultural tradition.
I think this is my obligation to continue and to work this way, because myself continue to grow and myself is without my hand, without her realm. And I think by using my hand to continue to grow this mother and child series, and I think this is my lifetime project. I can very confident to say I don't have project. I only found different ways of thinking of mother and child, into different ways of making mother and child, and different stage of how I grow and how I think, and all the influence from my family and from my mother. Always one space and form and everything, and then just one very important moment in my life, my work started total change. All these twisted forms and all these multiple pieces, and how her body changed, how twisted all these forms, and every single details is always I remember in my life. In my heart, so all this work is hard.
About 2 years ago, I got really excited about mold making and the possibilities of being able to make different shapes. And because I started off as a potter, and on the pottery wheel, and just thought of the pottery wheel as like the end all of ceramics. Was the coolest thing about ceramics. It was the only thing about ceramics, for me. And then I learned, when I came to the Art Institute, Kansas City Art Institute, I learned slip casting from my professor, George Timock, who had learned that from a place in Kecskemét, Hungary. And so I learned from him about slip casting, and was just really amazed at the possibilities of being able to make different shapes, because I'd been tired of making everything circular. I was looking for a way to get around that. So right now, I'm basically trying to be as experimental as possible at trying to find new ways to make molds. I feel like what the symposium has done is giving me an insight into like another aspect of my work, which is like product design, making things that are more focused towards a general audience that, you know, could potentially be, you know, some kind of financial, you know, stability for me in the future. And so what the working in the factory has done, I think, is shown me just really great ways to streamline production and, you know, work out issues with my mold making and, you know, casting processes and things like that. But yeah, it's, and being able to work with really nice clay and, you know, things like that. But yeah, it's nice to see. I think with the presentations that we're doing are really great, and just being able to get some insight into people's working methods and the like, just philosophies of making and everything. It's been really, I think that's what I get the most out of interacting with artists, because I mean, I think ceramic processes in general are pretty, like, once you learn them, you know, there's really no secrets anymore. And so what really is interesting to me at this point is seeing how people come to their conclusions, you know, come to their thinking processes.